Hey guys, Shifu Matt from the Shaolin Wing Chun organisation. Today we'll be demonstrating how to correctly perform the Huen Sao technique in your Wing Chun forms. So when you're performing the Huen Sao technique, it's important that you understand why you're doing it and how to do it correctly as well. So the reason why we do the Huen Sao technique in the forms is to develop our forearm strength, develop the flexibility in our wrist, and also strengthen the tendons and the joints there. And one other reason would be to isolate each of the joints individually. And so I'll demonstrate this so you can see it and also hopefully understand what I mean by isolating. So if you have a look at my arm, I'm rotating or circling my hand without moving my elbow joint. It would not be this way. So there's no isolation here at all. Both my elbow and my wrist are moving at the same time. So the correct way of doing it, I rotate my hand, I circle my hand around while I keep this pointing upwards, not this. And like you can see, if I do it correctly, it actually engages these muscles. It strengthens and lengthens, and also makes this quite flexible in the wrist here. But when I don't do it correctly, I'm not working any of these muscles in the arm. And Huen Sao can be performed in both directions, but the important thing to take away is that you have to do it correctly to actually develop this flexibility and strength in the forearm and the wrist and the hand. If you don't do it correctly, you won't be developing the correct muscles that we need in our forms and in a lot of techniques we use. So this will be one way. I rotate, circle here, and then the other way. But you can see the key thing is this point of my elbow doesn't move, it still points up. Otherwise, we might as well do it like this and circle, and then we'd be missing the point of doing the Huen Sao at all.